Cover crops can be a great tool for Ontario farms, but it's important to consider your goals when you're selecting those cover crops. And you need to consider where and how those cover crops are going to fit in your cropping system.
We mostly cash crop farm here. We grow corn, grain corn, sweet corn, soybeans, black edible beans, winter wheat, processing peas, buckwheat as a second crop after processing peas, a bit of hay. We also feed about 65, 70 head of cattle every winter time. And our rotation is probably roughly a third wheat, a third corn, and about a third legumes. We try to leave our soil covered as close to 365 days a year as we can. It's bad if we do not see some green or something living on that soil. We've always had livestock. You never have enough manure. And some of the sand knolls were being blown away in the old days. You used to moldboard plow everything. We ended up running across a bit of rye from some folks we know, and sprinkled it on the ground, on the sand knolls, and worked it in, and wow, it worked. Gradually now, all our acreage is covered every year. My advice to new growers, keep it simple, keep it small, something you can handle, and use clean, inexpensive seed.
Start with what your machinery can handle. Keep your capital costs low. We didn't buy a new line of machinery to handle residue management sort of thing. Rye has been the backbone of our cover crops. A bushel per acre, when it grows up, that's lots. We use it on ground we till, we'll spread bulk spread rye and chop, chisel plow it in. Ground we no-till, we use our 750 grain drill and we move the units a bit and we run up and down the rows, so we're planting rye in the corn we're going to no-till beans into next year. The buckwheat I'm holding right now, it's very fast growing. It's a smother cover crop. It'll smother out other weeds if it gets ahead of everything. This plant here is only about 4 weeks old. So you can see it grows fast if you get a rain. If you don't get a rain, it doesn't grow.
Cover crops have allowed us to reduce our fertilizer inputs, prevent wind erosion, prevent water erosion, decrease our supplemental nutrient needs, protect all the little critters below the ground level. Bill and I will drive down some roads and you see bare ground and you think, why?
The reason we got into interseeding is we are pretty convinced that cover crops help the soil and help the next crops. And when we looked at our overall system, getting the cover crop established after corn harvest was a little difficult for timing, and B, a lot of times too late to get good coverage. What I have come up with as my best mix is annual ryegrass and oilseed radish. Radish for the soil tilth, and it uses up a little bit of extra fertility and kind of cycles it. The ryegrass, so we have something that overwinters and we have something to hold the soil, or some kind of green material when we get there in the spring. And something that I haven't had issues with controlling is annual ryegrass. So some people see a radish like this and think that's what they want. They want these great big radishes with great big roots to break up their plow pan or their hard pan. It's not this part of the root that's doing the work. It's the part that we can't get out of the ground, the hair. So even a radish this size is doing you a lot of good because it's growing through the soil and breaking up that hard pan. You don't have to crack it wide open like the soil is when you have one of these at the top, because that's not the soil that I want to get broke up. It's the soil below that we need better to make better infiltration. In here you'll see we have a lot of smaller radish, and if you get into the row where we seeded, you can see the ryegrass is established around the radish. The ryegrass isn't that thick yet, but there's even small ryegrass plants you can barely see that after the fall and after the winter, we'll end up with a fairly, if with a stand like this, we'd end up with almost a lawn in between the rows. Now we're in 30-inch rows for corn and we plant 15-inch rows for soybeans. So the soybean planter is actually running 7.5 inches off of this stalk on each side. So we're taking advantage of the root tillage done by the corn plant, where we're over here. Plus we have the tillage done by the tillage radish on this side. So what we found with no-till soybeans, where we've had a good cover established, is better soil coverage of the soybean seed without having to deepen in the drill or the planter. And the planter tends to maintain its depth and ground contact a little bit better where we have a decent cover.
What do cover crops do for you? Why are you using cover crops, and why do you continue to use cover crops?
For erosion control, you're always after the top growth to slow down the wind, to keep the soil in place. But what we've learned over the years is to keep the soil healthy, it's the root system that you have. So the number one job it's doing for us is soil conditioning. So when I say soil conditioning, it means different things in different crops. For soybeans, it's giving us some soil tilth in between the rows. We're taking advantage of two growing root zones to make sure we have loose and friable soil to get our soybean seed covered and properly placed. In corn and sugar beets and tomatoes, we are interseeding the rows, the inner row space in the fall with a cover crop. And what we want is that cover crop is going to do two or three things. It's going to help control erosion. The roots are going to help with infiltration. The trash is going to help with retaining soil when you get a heavy downpour. You have a bit of a soil armor there, so you're not splashing the water drop on the dirt. It's hitting a leaf and diffusing the pressure. The other thing that we've started to be able to bank on is we are keeping better control of hard to control species of weeds, particularly Roundup Ready weeds or Roundup resistant weeds.
So the field we're standing in is a field of sorghum right now. It was winter wheat. We harvested the winter wheat, baled the straw, and then no-tilled the sorghum in here about 36 days ago. So what you see here is 36 days of growth. This has no commercial fertilizer on it. We did spread some liquid manure on it and some solid manure on it. So that did help. We'll cut this for feed for the cow. So in about 2 or 3 weeks, so about middle to the end of September, we'll cut this. We'll bale it, wet bale it, and wrap it in plastic. And this will be winter feed to help offset some of the needs of our cows during the winter months, the cold winter months when they're out grazing. Once it's cut off and baled, then we'll spread rye on top of here. Just plain cereal rye, about a bushel and a half to the acre, to give us a bit of growth. We'll see a little bit of growth in the fall, but mostly in the spring. So this will be our spring grazing area. So in the spring, we'll have a bunch of cows out here. Once we're done calving, or pretty well done calving, the cows will come off of this field and it'll be no-tilled into soybeans or corn. Planting a cover crop into winter wheat is easy. We've got a huge window of opportunity. We've got numerous choices we can make. We use sorghum just because we have an alternative use for it. Commercial corn has always been our challenge. Soybeans aren't bad. We do have a bit of window to get cover crop in soybeans. Commercial corn's always been a challenge because it's harvested so late. We don't have enough heat. We don't have enough growing days before winter sets in to get a cover crop established. What we're doing now is we're seeding it, air seeding it with a helicopter in about middle to the end of September. And that's working out really well. We just drop plain old cereal rye. The helicopter has a spinner on it and it'll spread it over top. We put on about a bushel and a half or 2 bushels of rye onto the field. That'll fall down in amongst the corn plants. By that time of year, the leaves are starting to dry up a bit. The plant's starting to open up the canopy so we can get a little bit of daylight down in there, and the rye has a pretty good head start. So this field will graze and we'll put cows on it all winter, and then into the spring the rye will come and take over, and the cows will have plenty to eat in that field, so they'll a great spot to calve. What we found with grazing corn stalks is an acre of corn stalks will do one cow for about 4 weeks. If we add a cover crop to it, that gains us 2 extra weeks of feed. The cover crop is really helping us buy extra weeks of feed into that field. Plus all the benefits that we have of the root growth and the erosion control and all the other great things that we could do with cover crop. We could not afford to pasture all this ground. We couldn't afford to put it into grass and just pasture cows on it. It just didn't make economic sense. But by growing crops, adding the cover crops to commercial crops, we get the best of both worlds. So we're cash cropping this ground, putting a cover crop in, and grazing cows on it. We're using it year round, and the cover crops have given us the ability to produce feed on that ground and graze cows quite successfully all year round.
So Mike, you said that you've applied some solid manure already and then you're applying some liquid manure to the cover crops. I'm assuming that you have an analysis that shows you the nutrients but also the organic matter. How did you incorporate them into that cover crop?
Yeah, so we don't add any commercial fertilizer to our cover crops at all. The only fertilizer they get is the manure. We're finding this liquid manure is working really good. It's giving us some available nitrogen right away, as well as some phosphorus and some potash on the side. So it's a good fit for the cover crops.
As we've seen, cover crops provide a number of different functions, from protecting from soil erosion, building better soil structure, providing livestock feed, and of course, suppressing herbicide-resistant weeds. As our farmers have shared, the key to getting started in cover crops, the key to success, start simple, start small, use clean seed, and pay attention to the details when you're planting. And this will help to ensure true cover crop success.